How do you sort out all these interest rates? One of the problems that exists right now in the world is that there's so many different interest rates. There's short-term rates, there's long-term rates, there's short long-term rates, there's 10-year, there's 30-year. And so with all of the different interest rates, when the word interest rate comes up, people tend to think that that just means interest rates, and aren't they all the same? But what happens is when the Fed makes a move, and that's where we've been watching interest rate fluctuations the most recently, when the Fed makes a move in interest rates, they're affecting a very, very short-term rate, the overnight rate that banks trade money or exchange money to one another. And that rate is in some ways related to mortgage rates, but only indirectly. And so when the Fed changes that rate, that doesn't mean that mortgage rates are going up by that same amount. In fact, sometimes when the Fed changes that rate in one direction, mortgage rates may go in the other direction. The things that affect mortgage rates are more of the confidence and the sentiment that exists in the economy or in the minds of those that are in the economy to feel whether they feel good about it or they feel bad about it. When there's lots of risk, investors don't like risk, so they need a bigger return. And so as a result, when there's risk in a market or uncertainty caused when the Fed's raising rates and a threat of a recession, that tends to cause a lot of fear out there in the investors, so they demand a bigger yield, and that causes your and my mortgage rate to go up to satisfy that investor yield. And so they are tied. The federal funds rate, the one that we've been watching that Chairman Powell has been upping a quarter a point or a half a point, and this time they didn't raise it at all, that rate, while it has some impact on mortgage rates, it's not direct. That is confusing to you. What I recommend is you DM us. Let's get together, get on a call, get in a dialogue, a text message thread, and we can help sort that out for you so that you don't think that because the Fed's going to lower rates three times next year, as they announced here recently, that that means rates are going down three times next year. Let's not make that assumption. Let's get our information right so you can make your best decision.